At exactly 8 a.m., the Inspector General of Government, Betty Kamia, was at the gate of the Directorate of Industrial Training, DIT, in Industrial Area Kampala for an impromptu visit that took staff by surprise. Kamia found most offices still closed during official working hours, with none of the top management available in office. She took a tour of the premises while chatting with other officers who had made it at work on time till towards 9 a.m. when the director of DIT, Patrick Byakatonda, showed up. Kamia called for a general meeting with all members of staff of DIT and preached the gospel of fighting corruption. She warned that those who are shying away from embracing the struggle against graft will catch up with them when they go out to seek public services like health.
We shall investigate that information and bring those people to book. Nobody is unimportant in this war.
Kamia noted that her visit to DIT is not a fishing expedition, saying they received information from whistleblowers about mismanagement of funds, fraud in staff recruitment by officials in the entity, and they decided to sanction an investigation.
Whistleblower accounts of lack of transparency and mismanagement, especially in staff recruitment and financial impropriety.
She constituted two teams composed of special investigation experts to investigate, first, the procurement plans and budgets of the entity, while Team 2 was tasked to investigate administration, human resource and governance.
It's mainly on administration, human resource and governance issues.
Kamia rallied staff to take advantage of the Whistleblowers Act, which provides 5% reward to a person who volunteers information that helps the government to recover stolen money. She urged them to use it to fight corruption while making money.
The whistleblower is entitled to 5% of the money that is recovered. That is a motivation.
The DIT director, Patrick Byakatonda, pledged to work with the investigating teams in the course of the probe to ensure they get any information required. He, however, decried limited staffing of the entity with only 20 staff on government payroll despite increased magnitude of work.
You can imagine only 20 staff on the government payroll. Eh? When the number has increased, the number of people of assessment has increased the number.
20.
Only 20 on a government payroll.
The IGG has allocated her team only 1 month to conclude this investigation and vowed to continue with impromptu visits to other government agencies. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.